Okay. Last time we discussed some problems and algorithms for these problems. For example, we discussed the problem of searching minimum. As you remember, the algorithm was like choosing randomly one of element and then step by step improve this choice. I mean, using Grover search, choose one of element that improves our choice that are less than AJ0. And we search one of these element using Grover search, and because of Grover search, we choose one of them with equal probability. And then on next iteration, we choose one, we try to improve again. So we choose one of element that less than existing our assumption for minimum and so on until there is no assumption. There is no elements less than our assumption. It means that it is the minimum. And okay. And last time I asked you to try to prove the complexity of this solution. Can you do it? Have you proved the complexity? Find the complexity of this algorithm. I cannot hear you. Your microphone.
I can barely hear you because there is a noise. I don't know, they're walking downstairs, I guess.
Mm-hmm. Okay, let me show you proof of complexity of this algorithm.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. There is a number m that is number of iterations until reaching the real minimum. Okay. In that case, let ti be running time of ith iteration. So we can say that ti is a random variable because it depends on the the running time depends on number of solutions. And the number of solutions, number of solutions can be different for each Grover search because we can randomly choose different element on the first step and next steps and next step. That's why this running time is random variable. Okay, and let T be total running time, that is sum of these running times on each iteration. And it is also running random variable, that is sum of these random variables. Okay. What we do now, as a first and main step, we compute the expected value of T. After that, we can discuss the running time of this algorithm or query complexity. Okay. Firstly, what we do, we represent this sum in little bit different way. What can be the running times of some steps? If there are only one solution for Grover search, it means that only one element less than existing than the assumption, then the running time is square root of n over one times some constant. Yeah, this pi over four and so on. We just put it in constant. If there are two solutions, then it's like this and so on. There can be different running times, and no term of this sum can meet twice. So I mean, if on one iteration running time is n over 10, for example, then it means that there are 10 different different elements less than the element than the in our assumption for minimum. And if when we choose one of them, then for next iteration, the at most 9 elements that less than our next assumption, because one of these 10 elements is will be the new improvement of our minimum. Yeah, that's why each the term of this sum can meet only once here in the sum T among this T1 and Tm. That's why we do, but num M can, M is also a random variable because we don't know how many iterations we have. That's why we can represent this T in a little bit different way. It is like a sum of this all possible complexities of row search iterations times Q, Qi. So this N over two times Q2 and so on, Qi. Or Qj will be indicator. It is zero or one. It means that is it included to our sum T or doesn't, we don't include. And it is a random variable with some probability and probability of one of these indicator, it is probability of obtaining such term in the in this sum. Okay, we will discuss it a little bit later. But if we represent our T in this way, in that case due to because T is linear, expected value is linear. That's why we can say that expected value of T, it is expected value of each of these terms. Sum of expected values. It is sum of these expected values. Because this, here random variable only this Qj is run are random variables here. That's why expected value is only on this Q1 and so on Qn, and other ones we put outside expected value. Yeah, we put it here. Okay, next, we if we compute expected value of Qj, then we can compute the expected value of T. Okay, let's look to this. Qj can have two values, zero or one. So this means that expected value is one times some probability of one plus zero times one minus probability of one. Because here zero, we just remove this term and get expected value is probability of one, let be Pj. So Pj is probability of occurrence of this some term, square root of n over j. When we obtain this term in sum, in the case when we have iteration in our algorithm, such that we choose some element ai on the previous iteration. And on this iteration, what we do? We search some element az that less than ai. And number of such elements is j. In that case, complexity of Grover search is n over j. So this means that we have this term square root of nj, and what we want, what the probability pj, it is the probability of choosing ai with this property on some step. Okay. So next. Okay, so what we want to compute. Pj is 1 over j. We'll show it later that it is 1 over j, at most 1 over j. Now, with this knowledge, we want to compute expected value of t. Okay, so what we have here, I just wrote, okay, here on each place it is times c, sorry, there is no times c here. Yeah. Here we have times c. It is c times such sum for j from 1 to n, 1 over j. It is probability of, it is expected value of qi, that is probability, qj, that's probability qj. Times square root of n over j. Yeah. What we do, we just split it to two parts. Well, one of them for j is one here. Yeah. And it's here. And another part is all other terms. I just put square root out, square root of n outside sum. And j collect all j's in this way, j to the minus 1.5. Okay. Next, what we do? We have this sum. All of elements are positive. That's why we can say that it is less or equal than we can replace sum by integral here. Yeah, from 2 to n. Why we do it? Because it's just easier to compute this integral than this sum, and we compute it. It will be like this from 2 to n, and we put it here constant minus 1 over 2 square root of n, and it is at most, we can remove this part, this constant. Here you can see that it is at most some constant times square root of n, and the total complexity is all square root of n. So this is expected value of running time, or expected value for number of square of queries for our for our Oracle. So number of queries. Okay. And if we know this expected value, then we can apply to Markov inequality for this expected value, and can say that running time or number of queries is O of square root of n with constant probability, for example, with 0.9. So it means that it is not about already not about expected value, but just for value with this probability. We can say that with probability O 0.9 in O of square root of n steps queries, we obtain the required minimum of all elements. If we have error, then we obtain not the minimal element, but some minimal that bigger than minimal. Do you have any questions?
No, I understood.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. Now let's show that this probability pj is at most 1 over j. Okay. So we do it by induction. It means that assume that we already know that for each. Okay. No, not. Sorry. For each z that bigger than j, this property is known. Yeah, it's not equal. Okay, if it's equal, we already know. Okay, for some for bigger elements, we already prove it. Let's show for pj. In that case, we can say that for all elements it's true. So let's consider the event bj. What is it? It's event that this term square root of n over j times constant is accurate in our sum for time t. In other words, what we discussed, it is that we choose on some iteration, we choose ai such that number of elements less than ai is j. Let's write it like rank of ai. It will be number of elements that less than this ai. So we on some step we consider the element such that rank is j. Okay, it is, we can say in other words, it is like if we sort our array of numbers, what will be the position of our this for this number ai, what will be the new position of this number in sorted array. Okay. So we choose ai with which have rank j on some step if this event happened, if exactly before this I, we choose some another element j I prime that have bigger rank, because it should be I should be chosen, and it should be chosen if it belongs to such similar set. And it means that it is less than some element ai prime. Then it means that we consider before that some element with bigger rank. Yeah. And let's denote event that ai was chosen, and after that I was chosen, so it just I prime was chosen. Element with index I prime was chosen just before the element with index I, and this event is di prime. So we can say that probability of di prime is, what is the probability? Firstly, we should before that choose this di. Yes, we should before that choose the element with index I prime. And after that, we invoke Grover search, and this Grover search will choose one of element with that less than ai prime with equal probability. And it means that choosing exactly ai, probability of choosing ai is 1 over z minus 1, where z is rank of this element a, sorry, prime should be here, not here, ai prime. So it is this probability after choosing ai in the element with index I. And we remember that we prove that this is 1 over z for each, if z bigger than J. So we discussed that it is this J that is bigger than J means that we know that probability P BZ is 1 over Z here. And it, what we obtain is probability of event di prime. Okay, so it's probability that exactly before I prime was chosen. Okay, and we can say that probability of this event BJ, yeah, here that this term occurred in our sum. It is probability of for obtaining the ion sum iteration. It is sum of probabilities of this events di prime for each I prime. For each I prime such that the rank grades J. So we can say that before element with index I can be some exactly before that some can be any of other elements with bigger rank. And this event doesn't intersect, doesn't overlap this event. That's why probability we can sum of these probability of these events and using this sum collect the probability of this one BJ. Okay. So then just technical work. We put PD replace PD I prime by this one over Z at minus one. So run can be from J plus one to M. We put it here and so we can, okay, sorry. Here one over Z square. So it is at most sum of one over Z square. We replace Z minus one by Z and yes. Oh, sorry. No, we cannot do it. We here should be something like sum that from J plus one here to N one over Z minus one square. Yeah, it is at most this. Replace Z by Z minus one and get bigger sum. But we can replace by a new variable that's not from J plus one, but from J to N minus one. Yeah, we do it. Here we replace it by, I don't know, X. Yeah, from J. Like this. Equal sum of X from J to N minus one, one over X square. This is what we need. In that case, X here, and it is at most, we replace sum by integral. Here J, here Z minus one. This is what we obtain. Okay, it is easy to compute this integral. We remove this here, but here minus one. Okay, this is what we obtain, and it is exactly one over J minus something like this. We can say that it is at most one over J. Okay, any question?
No, though. Pretty clear.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. So it means that we can say that we can search minimum square root of n steps.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, actually, I was kind of surprised that the proof start by saying that we use at most square root of n as steps, like in the algorithm proposed, but the proof actually formally demonstrates that the total complexity using robot search is square root of n.
Yeah, it happens exactly because the Grover search of each iteration, not exactly square root of n, but square root of n over number of solutions. And because of this factor, we can prove that this total sum is square root of n. Okay. So, okay, let's continue. Okay, we already discussed this idea. We discussed the problems finding the first one or minimal argument such that f on x is 1. We discussed that it can be, we can consider a new function ji that is one minus function fi and I, this pair, and and what we search exactly, it is lexicographical minimum of this such x, that it is lexicographical minimum of all others, because in that case the first element will be 0, so it means that fx is 1 and x will be minimum of them. And we use this minimum search and can obtain this complexity O of square root of n.
Yeah.
But you suggested another solution on binary search, as I remember. Let's discuss it. And
It was a binary search on the and the fact of the system of a solution. So if we step at the middle and there are solutions lesser than the middle, then the minimum solution is before the middle. If there are not solutions lesser than the middle, then the minimum solution is after. So we can do a binary search in the position of the solution.
Good, and sometimes this approach better
is
than
square than root of n times log n.
Let's discuss how to little bit change your approach with binary search and obtain still square root of n without log n. Okay. So firstly, 1 second. We know that there is such element. So let us consider, just let me explain your solution a little bit formally, because in that case it will be easier to understand what the complexity is here. We consider some segment of indexes from L to R, and we know that there is some solution fi here. What we do, we consider middle of them and check if from L to middle there exists some solution. Let's Grover search return 1 or 2 that it exists, or not. If there exists one solution, then we just update middle. We update right border by middle, and we consider. So we have this total segment of indexes consider minimum. If there is solution, then we on next step consider only this part. If there is no solution, then we consider this part. We always stay on the segment where the first solution exists. Okay, I think that is what you suggested. So let's consider the complexity of this this algorithm.
Okay, that's just my solution. Just the complexity is better calculated, and it's not. It is just square root of n.
Yeah. You can see that because the size of segment on each next step is twice less, twice smaller. Then we can write it like this. Put n here, and we obtain geometry. Progression, sum of geometric progression, and that's why it will be just constant. The total square root of n. But we have a problem that is success probability is very small because for each square Grover search, the success probability is some constant, for example, 1/2, because we don't know how many solutions there are. And we have log n steps of binary search, and the total success probability is 1/n. Not very good. The improvement that I suggest is only improvement that allow us to increase the success probability with still the same complexity. What we do? We can, so if we assume that this is first step of binary search, second step, third step, and so on the ith step of of binary search, we repeat our Grover search 2i times. We repeat it, and so for this left part, if at least one of them say that there is a solution, then we assume that it is one. Yeah. If all of them say there is no solution on the left part, then we say that there is no solution and go to the right part and move left border to the middle. Yeah. Let's consider what happens with complexity in that case and what happens with success probability in that case. So what happens with complexity? We have here square root of n first, then 2 times, okay, just for same form, I write 2 times n times 1 because I is 1 here, square root of n over 2. Okay, because it is, then here is 2 times 2 n over square root of 2 to the 2, then 2 times 3 times n over square root of 2 to the 3, and so on, and 2 times log n square root of n over 2 to log n. Yeah. We collect it together in one sum, and here I. Yeah, here was 1, here I. But still, if you compute this sum of geometry progression, then we can see that it is still O of square. So this this one will be O of square root of n. Yeah, just by computing this sum, by using the formula of geometry progression. Okay, but what happens with, so complexity will be about the same, yes, square root of n, but what about the success probability? So if we repeat it 2i times, so it means that error probability of one Grover search location is at most 1/2. Yeah, for two Grover search location is 1/4, and I 2i Grover search invocations, it is 1 over 4 to the i is error probability. Yeah, it is what we discussed on the previous meeting, that by repeating Grover search, we obtain the smaller error probability. We multiply error probability, okay? Because all of invocations should give us error. Okay, in that case, we don't need this part. Okay, so it means that total error probability is, because we invoke it one by one, the sum of these errors of each of these events, error on the first step of binary search, second step of binary search, and so on. It is sum of this. It is again sum of geometry progression, just to show that upper bound of this is sum for until infinity. That is 1/3. So we can see that in that case, the error probability is not success probability like here, but error probability here is at most constant 1/3. Here was here error probability was close to one when n is enough big, but here it at most constant. But using this trick, we obtain this constant error probability with still good complexity. Yeah? Any questions? Clear? Or not?
No, I got it.
Mm-hmm. Okay, good. So let's move next. So we discussed. Sorry. Before this problem, let's go back. Okay. Before this problem, let's go back to our problem, Nietzsche. This one, yeah. I also asked you to suggest some, if we know that complexity of this problem is O of square root of n, suggest some another modification of this algorithm such that complexity is O of square root of x, where x is our solution. Do you have some idea for this algorithm?
To be honest, I hadn't thought much about it. So I don't have an idea yet. Mm-hmm. If we want to discuss it now, I don't mind. If we can get more time, I don't know.
Okay, maybe I will just tell you the idea.
Okay.
So the main, so here for obtain this complexity, we want to use a trick with sum of geometry progression G. So just sum of some complexity that increase it twice and what we obtain, it is the complexity of the biggest term. Yeah. So, and here, and then what we do. So consider the our function, like for example, as array and somewhere, so these indexes, yeah, and somewhere here we have one. One here and one here. Yeah, and one here. What we want to find this index. What we do? We use trick that somehow similar to binary search or to binary lifting that used in trees for LCA problem, for example, The trick is following. What we do? Firstly, we check whether exists any one in part from one to two.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I think I got it. Do like the binary lifting for constructing the range minimum or maximum query. Like, I'm going to check the first position. If that's not my solution, I'm going to check two positions. Then I'm going to check four. I'll keep doubling until I pick for the first time a range that have a solution. Now, I know that my solution is in the last doubling section. So that's the square root of x, yeah?
Yeah, yes, exactly. So we firstly we search in the segment from 1 to 2, then from 1 to 4, then from 1 to 8, double it, until we obtain the situation when we have at least one solution in this part. Yeah, and we can say that the size of this segment will be big. So let it be 2 to the j, yeah, size of them. And we can say that it is less than 2 to the j plus 1. Yeah, and so x between 2 to the j plus 1 and 2 to the j.
And 2 to the j, yeah.
No, I think even we can say that it is between j and...
And 2 j minus 1.
J minus 1, yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It means that the size of our... our segment is at most 2x. Yeah, we can say that 2 to the j is at most 2x.
2x. Mm-hmm.
So, and the complexity, what we for all these Grover search algorithms are square root of 2
of x
plus so on 2 to the j. Square root of 2 to the j, that is, so this sum is because of Grover's, geometry progression, it is O of square root of 2 to the j, yeah, that is O of square root of x.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So now we know that here we have solution, and then we invoke the existing algorithm of searching the first one. But in this segment, that will also have complexity O of square root of 2 to the j. That is...
That segment has 2 to the j elements at most, so that complexity is square root of x. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so... Exactly. And so that... That's why we obtain, okay, what we have. And so we have this complex square root of x here. Well, what we get. But here can be also small.
Success probability.
Yes, success probability can be small error probability, but we apply similar trick like with binary search. And, then here with success probability, small error probability, and with still the same complexity. Okay? Any questions?
Okay. No, it's pretty clear.
Okay, good. Another way if we focus. So without this trick by several times repeating in binary search, if we focus only on algorithm of searching first one using minimum search algorithm, It can be the same complex can be proven little bit other way. So we do the same, but don't invoke here Grover search. We invoke this searching minimum first one on each step. So, but if there is no one, it returns. So there is no solution. No solution. Uh-huh. But here is one. Here there is solution, and it is here. And in that case, what we do, we just compute expected value of each of these steps, time for each steps. We say that total time is expected value of total time will be sum of expected values of each complex of each step. And be T1 plus so on plus Tj. Yeah, because so it should be expected value of sum of them, but because of the expected value is linear, we can say that it is sum of expected values. Each of them is exactly the square root of 2 here and so on, square root of n here times some constant. We sum it and obtain again expected value is, well, expected value is some O of square root of n. And again, by Markov inequality, we say that, oh, sorry, not n, but x here. Yeah, and here also square root of x. Yeah, and by Markov inequality, we obtain that complexity is square root of x. So the it is like we don't use that trick, but we use linearity of expected value, and because we computed expected value for this minimum search, we obtain this total expected value. Okay? Is it clear? Oh, sometimes it is easier maybe by this compute complexity by this one. Okay, let's continue. And one, just one more problem. This one. So now the problem is find all solutions of our function. We know that there is several solutions and we want to find all of them. How to do it? What do you think?
I mean, a really straightforward approach will be apply find first. Mm-hmm. And then apply find first again from the next position until the end. Mm-hmm. Until there is no more positions to search for.
Okay, good. Yeah, that is what I want from you. It is so. What we do, we find this first. Yes, first one, then second one. Find first again from in this mm-hmm. part, then find first again in this part, and so on until we don't obtain anything.
Uh-huh. Let's
compute the complexity here. So if position of first one is k1, here k2, for example, k3, yeah, we have square root of this part, plus
a square root of this plus square root of,
yeah, and so on. Mm-hmm. Square root of all of sum of these parts. Yeah, let me try it. Like here, mm-hmm. square root of k1 plus square root of k2 minus k1 plus so on plus square root of
kn.
So it is n minus last. If let we have t solutions kt.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have this Вот так. Окей, by Каши, Шварц, Буниковский inequality, we know that sum of square roots is at most square root of sum times
of the sum
number of elements, it is t times sum of them. K1 plus K2 minus K1 plus K3 minus K2, plus so on, plus K, let me, KT,
M minus KT.
M minus KT, yeah? And you can see that here K1 minus K1, K2 minus K2, and so on, yeah? Let's be...
The answer.
Minus zero. The same for. And we, yeah, we remove all of them, and we get a square root
Tn.
Times n. Yeah? And... okay, we can say that because we use, for example, the solution of, for searching first one, the solution with that use minimal search, we can say that expected value of total this square complexity is sum of expected values of this one. It is exactly the square root of this one because of linearity of expect value, and the expect value is square root of t times n. And by Michael Markov inequality is the same, the complexity will be square root of tn. And also, I will not show you, but there is lower bound that we cannot construct any algorithm, quantum algorithm that finds better than this one. So it is upper and lower bound.
Okay.
And sometimes we will use it. So, okay, for today it's enough. And for example, this idea will be used in some in quantum versions of some graph algorithms, which we will discuss next time. I think that next time we will focus on some graph algorithms.
Okay.
Let me see. Okay.